Hello everyone, welcome to Apigee 4-Minute Videos for Developers, part of Programming of API series. In this video, we're going to talk about API proxy in Apigee Edge. Myself, Anil Sagar, I work at Google on Apigee platform. Prerequisites for this video, you need an Apigee Edge account, which is free, and register at apigee.com/edge. In this video, we're going to see how API proxy works in Apigee Edge to create a simple API proxy for your existing API and do an API management like simple API transformation in Apigee Edge. API proxy in Apigee Edge, let's see how it works. Let's say you have a backend which is exposing data through services like simple REST APIs or even legacy APIs, which will be consumed by the app. App makes a simple request to the backend and gets back the response. But to do API management, you need an API layer which you can leverage for API management functionality. That's where exactly Apigee Edge fits in. So you can able to do API management in Apigee Edge without even changing your legacy services or even your backend systems, which are built over the time. Your client sends request to Apigee Edge where you can do API management on Apigee Edge, and Apigee sends the same request to the client and then gets back the response. And again, you can able to do the API management in the response flow and send back the response to the client. So you can do all this in seamlessly because Apigee's Edge sits in between the client and the backend. You can able to do all the API management functionality in Apigee Edge. And in this video, we're going to see a simple API transformation from JSON to XML and then send back the response to the client. Let's get started. You need an Apigee Edge account. Once you are logged in, your Apigee Edge dashboard looks like similar to this. To create an API proxy, click on Develop and then click on API Proxies. Once you are in the screen, click on API Proxy to create a new proxy. We're going to use a simple backend, a mockdocket.apigee.net/json, which gives a simple JSON response back to the client, first name, last name, city, and state. We're going to create a proxy for this target backend. So this is our target API. Click on API Proxy. You'll see an API proxy wizard. We're going to use reverse proxy type. So I'm going to say Apigee 4MB4D proxy and use the existing API URL as mockdocket.apigee.net/json. Click on next, select the security as pass-through and choose the defaults to create an API proxy. There you go. We have just created an Apigee API proxy in Apigee Edge platform. Let's make a call to the API proxy to access the target system. As you can see, when I made a call to Apigee 4MV4E, apigee.apigee.net/4MV4proxy, we see the same JSON response as the target API. Let's use the trace to see everything in action. As we've seen in earlier slide, the client makes a call to the Apigee. Apigee makes a call to the target system, and then target sends the response back to the Apigee. Apigee sends the response back to the client. You'll have access to full request and response where you can do API management. Let's do a simple API transformation like JSON to XML. I have added a simple JSON to XML policy to the response flow and saved the API proxy. If I make the same API call now, I will see an XML response instead of JSON response, as you can see. So you can able to do all the API management in Apigee Edge. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, please feel free to post your questions on community.apigee.com. Keep watching this space and subscribe for more videos. Thank you.